Welcome everybody to, and thank you all for joining us this Saturday afternoon to celebrate the conclusion of the Environmental Education Collaborative Art and Writing Contest. Today we will be announcing and celebrating the winners. This the year's theme was Air and Justice, and you'll see all the wonderful entries shortly. My name is Katie Porter, and I am Executive Director of Inlandia Institute, a literary and cultural arts nonprofit based in inland Southern California. And we are a proud partner for this contest. Before we begin, Inlandia Institute respectfully acknowledges and recognizes our responsibility to the original and current caretakers of this land, water, and air. The Kaweah, Tongva, Luiseno, and Serrano peoples, and all of their ancestors and descendants, past, present, and future. Today, the Inlandia region is home to many indigenous peoples from all over the world, and we express our gratitude to them for allowing us the opportunity to live and work on these homelands. And now I just want to go over a few housekeeping notes. Bear with me just a half a second. I do want to let you know that there is a closed captioning available. If you click the CC icon at the bottom of your screen. And also for our winners who are in the audience, please listen for your name and use the raise your hand function, which is located in the reactions button at the bottom of your screen, so that when you hear your name, raise your hand and we will promote you to panelist. If you would like to say a few words about your piece, or if you would like to share it, if it was a literary entry. And also please note that this event is being recorded. And for those of you who are in the audience and are a winner, but would like not to speak, that's perfectly okay too. No obligation. And so at this time, I would like to introduce Jen Futterman, who is an EEC board member, and she is the contest coordinator. And she will tell you a little bit more about this event and this contest. And Jen, you're on mute.
Thank you. Sorry about that. Yeah. Hi, everyone. Happy World Environment Day. I'm Jen Futterman, one of the original Environmental Education Collaborative board members. I'm a sustainability commissioner for the city of Palm Springs, and I'm the coordinator of this annual environmental art contest since 2005. The Environmental Education Collaborative, also known as the EEC, is a true gem in the inland area of Southern California, bringing together amazing people in support of environmental education programs. Our mission is to create a sustainable and just future through environmental learning experiences for everyone. The EEC became the host of this contest in 2019, and it's the perfect home for this project serving Riverside and San Bernardino counties. I have had the pleasure of coordinating this contest as a place for visual artists to shine, each year presenting a theme of one of the five elements to inspire critical thinking skills expressed in a creative way as it relates to the artist's interpretation and vision. We added the theme this year of justice with air as a means for artists to speak up for justice and speak out against injustices they might want to address in this day and age. 2021 is the first year we opened the contest to literary and performing artists as well, which inspired our new partnership with Inlandia Institute that we're absolutely delighted about. Under normal circumstances, we would have an in-person World Environment Day event in Palm Springs, sponsored by the City of Palm Springs Sustainability Commission. So this has served as a place to view the environmental art show and host the award ceremony for years. Last year in 2020, the EEC was able to provide a virtual art contest, but we didn't have an actual award ceremony. So we're really happy to have you here with us for our very first virtual art award ceremony to honor and celebrate our artists. The judges were truly blown away this year by the talent and passion seen, and selecting the winners was really a challenge for everyone, as all the entries were really truly worthy of praise. Today you'll see the best of the best and be introduced to all the artists who could be here to join us this afternoon. Without further ado, we'll present this year's Air and Justice winners. So first we have preschool and TK. Ellie Gonzalez is our first winner. Ellie, are you here?
So I believe someone is here on their behalf. So let me add the spotlight.
Good.
So Eric Gonzalez.
Yes, I'm the dad. So this is Ellie here.
Say hi. Hi.
Okay. He keeps wanting to change the page on me. Okay.
Congratulations, so nice Ellie. You.
Thank you.
And thank you for submitting such a beautiful art piece.
Yeah.
Oh, back to kindergarten. Our kindergarten winner, Solomon Ikahihifo. Are you here with us, Solomon?
I don't see any hands raised. Oh, no, we have them.
Oh, good.
Good. And if you start your video, then I can spotlight you and you can say hello. Okay. I'm not sure. If you're able to unmute and speak. Okay. Well, it looks like maybe they're having some technical difficulties. So.
Okay. Okay. Well, we're glad you're here with us to celebrate. Great piece. Amazing. Our first grade winner, Brewer Fierro. Are you here, Brewer?
I don't see a hand raised.
Okay, congratulations, first grade winner. Our second grade winner, Noah Villeta. Are you here with us?
What? Yes.
Oh, good.
And if you could start your camera, then we can bring you on screen.
Are you there yet?
There you are.
Hi, he's not available. I don't think he realized that he won, but I'm his, I helped him with his art and I'm his grandmother and we are proud to be a part of this.
Oh, good. Thank you for being here. We didn't have a third grade entry, and so we're moving right to fourth grade. Erica Gonzalez, congratulations. Are you here?
I see a hand. Okay, so let me make it.
Hi, we hear you.
You should be able to see them now. Oh, hello again.
Yes.
Multiple winners in the same family. Yay. Okay.
Anything you want to share, Erica?
Thank you.
Thank you so much for participating. It's absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
Our fifth grade winner is Sophie Gonzalez. Are you here with us, Sophie? Well, we congratulate you. Our sixth grade winners, Leo Wen. I'm hoping you're here to read this to us.
I see them in the audience, and I've just brought them to the panelists. So. let me see. Here we go. Hello.
Hi, Leo. Congratulations.
Thank you. I really am devoted to helping stop this this carbon enter this atmosphere.
Thank you. We need you as our youth up and coming citizens to help us with this problem. Will you read to us what your piece says?
Oh, sure. Every year, millions of poor people suffer diseases caused by air pollution, including asthma, sometimes bronchitis or something.
Bronchitis.
And oil and gas companies don't pay the price normally. They simply should.
I agree 100%. Thank you so much. What a powerful piece. Powerful message.
So we have a hand raised from Alicia Washington. Was she one of the previous winners? Or maybe they lowered their hand. Okay.
So this was a tie with Leo and our other sixth grade winner, Jada Franklin. Jada, are you here?
Hello again.
It's me, grandmother, again.
good.
I know Jada wasn't here again today. She had to actually attend a funeral, so I apologize for it. Her mother didn't know about it, but I know she wanted to talk about the mask and how the mask represented, you know, not just the atmosphere, but how wearing masks because the environment is bad as well. I know that was one of the points she wanted to walk out and that we need a clear environment. So I know that was one of the things that she wanted to point out.
Well, in this year with the pandemic, it's really a powerful visual piece that she created. So please congratulate her for us.
Thank you.
And here we have a sixth grade winner, Narali Campos, and she wrote an essay. Are you here to share your essay with us, Narali?
Sure.
I did speak to her, so I think she was going to try to make it. There you are.
Hi.
Would you like to read your essay, Narali, or an excerpt?
Can I choose my favorite paragraph?
Sure. Do you need it on the screen? Or do you have it?
Yes.
Okay. We're going ahead of ourselves. This is a little tricky with the tech, so hang on a second while I get the essay up. There we go. Which paragraph would you like to read?
The second. To start off, I am sure you know that smoking can damage your health, but we aren't going to talk much about that. What you should know is how it affects the environment. If you have ever seen somewhere, it could have been a movie, a show, in the store, anywhere someone's smoking, you have noticed the smoke that releases while they are smoking, and that smoke releases toxic chemicals into the air. Another cause from that smoking is what the air in the environment is. That with the chemicals it releases, it also causes global warming. Global warming is a big problem in the world that is caused by smoking. Clearly, smoking can cause damage to your health, but it can also damage the air and environment.
Well, thank you so much, Natalie, for sharing that, for your powerful essay.
Yes, thank you, Natalie. Amazing work.
Go back.
Seventh grade, Noemi Anaya. Congratulations, Noemi. Are you here with us?
I do not see a hand raised, but I see a question in the Q&A box. Let me see. I just have to check. Oh, okay. We had a question about how to turn on their mic, but thank you. We have someone in addressing that. Perfect. And it doesn't look like Noemi is here, so.
And we had two seventh grade winners in this category. So this was a tie. Emma Zuko, are you here to share with us about air injustice?
Yes, she is here.
Wonderful.
And on screen.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, Emma.
I'm just really happy that I was able to participate in this. And for me, what this means is that everything was created perfectly, and everyone and this virus, they just made it harder for everyone. Some parents or families couldn't see their grandparents, and everyone was just sad and mad about that, and everyone was dying, and there was like no place for the hospitals and all that, and everyone needed to wear a mask, and some people weren't able to buy any and had to wear the same one every single day, and some people, they just bought them for every single day, new ones and new ones. But those people who couldn't afford it, they had to struggle wearing that same mask every day, not even washing. Maybe they didn't even have water. And this is just really important to me, because we should all stick in this together, in this air injustice. Because we need to show that we're here for everyone. We're here to help you. If you need this, we'll try to help you and all that. So yeah, that's what my art means to me.
It's powerful. Thank you so much for sharing about your art. This is a seventh grade literary art contestant. Elizabeth Tolentino, are you with us to share about your infographic?
I
wonder if it can it be enlarged?
I'll make it a little bit bigger. Let me bring her on screen and then.
Sure.
Okay. So she should be on screen now. And
Oh, I think you might have spotlighted me instead.
Oh, whoops. Hi, Mary. Okay. Try this again. Oh, maybe Elizabeth, if you could turn your camera on, then I can put you on screen if you would like. Or you can just unmute yourself if you'd like to speak. No? Well, let me make this a little bit bigger if I can. But, not responding. I'm gonna see if I can open it in a different window. And Elizabeth, if you want to speak, just unmute yourself and I would be more than happy to bring you on.
Can you hear me?
Oh, I hear you, or I heard you briefly.
Did I read it?
Sure.
Okay.
Trying to center it.
It says, don't drive a car too much. It releases unhealthy gas. Instead, use a bike or a train. Don't set wood on fire. It releases unhealthy gas to the air. Instead, the wood contains toxic chemicals. Burning wood creates toxic chemicals, unhealthy to breathe. Don't leave your lights on for too long. Lights need fossil fuel, which is a component of air pollution. So the more lights, the more light, the more fuel, the more fossil fuel.
Thank you so much for this. What good tips to remind us. This is our eighth grade winner, Shirley Salgado. Are you here to share with us?
No, I don't see a hand going up.
Well, this one's interesting. It's in Spanish, so I love this. It's even if you don't speak Spanish, she did such a good job of depicting what she wrote about, so you can see which world you'd prefer to live in. We had a tie here, so eighth grade Tanishka Matha. Are you here so that we can congratulate you live?
I don't see a hand.
All right, let's save Earth together. Let's do that. Our eighth grade literary art winner is Sabrina Mazet. Are you here with us?
I don't see a hand. Would you like me to open it? Is this to read or is this a video?
It is a video. Thank you. Thank you, Sabrina, for your wonderful PSA. Really powerful imagery.
And okay.
Our ninth grade winner, Kylie Rhodes. This very visual of what we're experiencing in this pandemic, isn't it? Are you here with us, Kylie?
I don't see a hand, so.
Okay. And our ninth grade winner in the performing arts, Sean Adams. We have a short film.
Okay.
Katie, can you turn up the volume?
Okay. So, viewers, I understand that you're not hearing the sound. I'm going to restart this. Give me just a moment. Let me stop the share and I'm right back.
Smog in the neighborhood.
This must be the work of Sinister Smog. What has he done this time? Let's go, Sidekick. Let's go thwart his plans.
Come to stop your plans.
Airman, I've been expecting you. This is the final time you'll get the last laugh, where I've created the Smoginator. And once I hit this button, the entire neighborhood will be covered in smog.
Sinister Smog, that's dirty. How could you do something like this?
Oh, you don't get it, do you? Once I take over this neighborhood, next comes the country, and then the entire world. Ha ha!
How dare you, Sinister Smog? I won't let you get away with it!
Looks like the smog is finally getting to you.
Sinister Smog, what have you done?
Well, you see, Airman, smog seems to be greatly effective against you.
Listen, give up. I need to push past my limits and defeat you! Oh!
Impossible! How could this be?
Called my air punch. I manipulate the air around my fist in order to create a powerful burst of air.
The smog will eventually get you if you go on any farther.
That's what you think, but I'm not done yet. Take this super AirPod! Once again, the day is saved. I think my work is done here.
Sean, are you with us? That was such an awesome video. We loved it. Well, congratulations for best of ninth grade video arts. And we actually had a tie for our performing artist, Sophia Borovia. Are you here with us? Well, we'll play your song. And if you're here, we'd love to congratulate you.
She is definitely here.
Oh, good. Good, good.
You need to turn on your video in order for me to spotlight you, or you can simply unmute if you'd like to speak. Okay, here we go. Please unmute. Thank you, you guys. If you want to say something, please click unmute.
It's on the bottom left corner. So maybe you'll play the song and if they can figure out how to unmute.
Yeah.
Okay.
So here, I'll come back to them. Let's see. Not sure why it's not playing. Bear with me a second.
I see the grass, so bright and green. I feel the air, calm and serene. I see the trees, so strong and big. From their nest of birds, to their mighty twigs, I hear the birds, singing their song. That encourages me to sing along. I see the sky, so clear and blue. The beauty of nature reminds me of you. We all need nature in our lives. Without nature, we wouldn't survive. Let's do our part every day. A little love goes a long way. So take care of nature for everyone. A little hard work soon becomes fun. So take care of nature for me and you. Take my word, for I know it's true.
We love your song, Sophia. Thank you so much for sharing. It's absolutely beautiful. Keep singing, sharing your message.
Trying to get back to where we were. Pardon the lots juggling.
Ninth grade literary art winner is Micah Remick. Are you here to share your essay or part of it?
I don't see a hand.
Also in ninth grade, we have Natalia Roman. Are you here to share your poem? Oh, good.
So,
hello, can you hear me?
Oh, yes, okay. Do you want to turn on your camera or just read?
I'll just read it for right now. But I wanted to thank you so much for allowing me to share my poem and for selecting me. So the poem that I wrote is called The Blue Line. The blue base that flows beyond reach, rushes to our feet, sleeps the slight tenderness of a cold drink to pedal down around our knees until our mind whispers in its sea. The base still moves in our sleep, without the tightness of our outreach, a lightness that needs not comforting, but alive to deepen with beauty, yet only if it's who we see. The blue line bounces in its sanity back to the beach, cold as a saturated metallity, filled with immortality from the ground's personality, acting as an image plastered with plastic wrapped tightly around its surrounding, a brightness dulling the pearl of the sea warming, cold and obliterated by the binding, mind swallowed by its rapacious coal, once was covered in gold with varnished coating was bold, everlasting the lustrous descending of its mere mortals, only to be destroyed by the fools who allowed for the debris its decimate the azure shore. For no more the coldness dashing our feet, flow and drip among our cheeks, energizing the warmth of our scene, torn away by our own indecency. A place that bounds our body, breaking down in calamities, snapping the blue line with each crack permitting, remaining the citizens holding the line, wrapping around as binding. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing, Natalia. We loved your poem. Our 10th grade visual arts winner, Allison Gwynn. Are you here?
I don't see her name in the audience and I don't see a hand.
So before you move on, just to point out, it's okay.
Going back.
Yeah. You know, you can see this, the mask, but look at the clothing. So just take note. You know, part of her piece was that this affects everyone. So whether you have money or you don't. So rich or poor, the pandemic as well as air quality are affecting everybody. So we had a tie for 10th grade. This is our other 10th grade winner, Sunny Ropel. Are you here?
Do not see a hand.
Okay, congratulations, Sunny. Eleventh grade, Kalila Kahin. Are you here to share about your art?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Okay. Unmute yourself, Kalila? Or did you just want to wave? Okay, hi. Okay, her camera's back on, so I think she just wanted to say hi.
Okay, congratulations, Kalila. Beautiful art. All also 11th grade winner, Amy Mendoza. Are you here for us to congratulate you and say a few words?
Yep, I see her in the audience.
Oh, good.
And Amy, if you turn your camera on, or if you just want to speak, unmute.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so my artwork demonstrates that us humans have a special connection with nature, such as leaves and trees. Trees produce oxygen, also known as air, and without air, we wouldn't be here.
Beautiful, very true.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.
12th grade visual arts winner, Ashley Galindo. Are you here with us, Ashley?
I do not see Ashley in the audience.
Okay. We had quite a few ties, so this is another 12th grade amazing piece. Genevieve Haslinger. Are you here with us, Genevieve?
Yes.
Perfect. Here she is.
Okay. But Genevieve, if you want to, yeah, there we go. Okay.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
All right, I just wanted to say a couple words about this piece, if that's all right. First, I wanted to say that I'm honored to accept the award, and I'm very grateful to the judges for the recognition. So as such, I would like to take the time to speak a bit about my piece. So this is entitled A Lone Traveler on the Western Landscape, and it is set in the Western United States around 1848. I used a variety of natural photo references from both California and Arizona deserts and mountains to construct the piece, painted digitally on a drawing tablet. I prefer digital pieces in general for their accessibility in creation and preservation and reduction of waste that traditional art may produce. For a bit of historical context, this is just before the California Gold Rush and right in between the first and second industrial revolutions. The aftermath of rampant industrialization was apparent, including extreme air pollution and disgusting violations of human rights and labor. The character I featured is of African descent and has become a traveler to escape the terrors of the industrialized American society, focusing on authentic blacksmith work to escape from machine standardization and drear. The United States and its territories were not kind to people of color during this time, and racial inequality continues to be a struggle every single day in this nation. The character can find justice through purity of the air untouched by pollution in Western territories relatively unscathed by these ills. It serves as a reminder of his inherent connection to the earth and relief from the social strife so prominent in the established United States. As we view for this from our modern lens, we can recognize the inherent darkness of the historical context behind the piece, as well as what we understand to be the future of the United States from that point. Although somewhat preserved by national parks efforts, there is no true place of peace and sanctity remaining in the US. Air and justice are both rapidly being taken, and that is why it is so important to continue creating art of all mediums to bring light to this matter and consider our rights when examining history and contemporary government.
Wow, thank you so much for sharing more about your piece so that everyone can have a greater understanding of the depth that you really considered going into this. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Beautiful piece. We have our 12th grade literary art winner, Avalon Provence. Are you here to share your poem?
It's here.
Perfect.
Hello. Thank you for recognizing my poem. Would you like me to read it, or is that okay?
Yes, please. Please read it. We'd love it.
Okay. So the title is called Ella, and this is in remembrance of a 9-year-old girl whose cause of death was declared air pollution. And this is in remembrance of her. The radiant sun set as inevitable night rose. Determined fists met the man-forsaken sky. An aura bright smothered by imperial gray. A blossom of daisy wilted, as heavenly angels cried. Nine sacred years seized by man's dangerous descent, an appetite for profit sought, truly an unrelenting yet flawed plan. Steady tears fall from heavy hearts. Another light lost, another work of creation undone. Okay.
So powerful, Evelyn.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing. It's beautiful. We have another amazing literary art winner, Jillian Anderson.
She's here.
Oh, super.
Hello. My story is more of a dystopian society piece, and I'm excited to share it with you guys. It's called Life Itself is Fleeting. What happens when you realize your life has been a lie? Living under a microscope, being constantly surveyed by people in white lab coats as they watch you from monitors. This civilization is known as the Dome. In the last 18 years of my existence, I have never been outside my home or cage, depending on how you look at it. The scientists have always warned us that the air is toxic to breathe. So toxic that anyone who tried to venture out into the beyond would suffocate in a matter of seconds. Who's to say rules weren't meant to be broken? Esme has always been a peculiar subject to document and gather data on. She seemed to grow more restless with age. Fear tactics won't work against her, and sooner or later, she'll come for us. She'll know that the truth lies just beyond her outstretched fingers, and the truth may shatter her. If her people knew that we lived in special pods with advanced ventilation systems, and we had the ability to do something about the environment, we would all be dead. It's easy to lie to people when there is no direct eye contact and all you see is them on a screen. They are merely blips and small ants waiting to be extinguished at any moment. Sooner or later, the project will be abandoned with hopes to start a new civilization elsewhere. It's only a matter of time before word gets out that our posts will be abandoned. There's no hope for them without the scientists. Their food comes from the labs, the seeds that allow crops to grow in the dome. Even the irrigation is filtered from up above through tubes, and the clean air is sealed in. If there were ever a hole in the dome, it could be catastrophic. The catastrophe started long ago, before scientists had the technology to figure out a way to create a sustainable civilization. There was death. Dead bodies covered the ground with bones spread out for miles and miles. Rotting flesh and bulging eyes, along with bloated bodies, seemed to accompany the living wherever they went. That's another thing you can't find in books. The immunes. Before the creation of the dome, they were those that scavenged the ground looking for any edible food to eat. And let's say the food was less than appetizing. Death always starts and ends in stages, so the parts that immunes could eat were eaten. As more immunes discovered others like them, it became clear that they had to spearhead an experiment to test the toxicity in the air and to see if it were possible to have living, breathing people roam the earth once again. Some scientists volunteered to be placed in the dome once the plans were finalized, and with those volunteers came babies, and those babies became adults who had babies of their own, all within the perfectly constructed confines of the dome. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Really creative writer you are, and very gifted. Thank you so much for reading it for us. And we move into our adult category. So we have a few adults to honor. Jesus Shushin Gonzalez, are you here with us today, Jesus?
Yes, he is here.
Oh, perfect.
Jesus, are you going to speak, or do you want to, if you want to be on camera, start your camera. Okay, here we go.
Hello.
Hello.
Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Perfect. Hi, I just wanted to say thank you for letting me share the story of the Trujillo Adobe, and maybe I just wanted to kind of read the caption that I enclosed with the picture to kind of better explain what the picture is. And it starts with, we are resilient and we thrive. Inside the shed is the last remaining wall of the community adobe in the once prosperous Latinx settlement called La Placita. Recently, the city of Riverside was going to approve an influx of industrial warehouses around the historical structure, an area that has historically been woefully neglected. The community has come together and voiced their opposition. Those plans have been put on hold while the city updates their Northside specific plan, which will be the guiding document in what the future look and feel of this community will be. It is through the power of community and collectively voicing our needs that we can manifest a more just and equitable future. That's not to say that it's an easy task or that opposing forces of money and power won't try to derail, chip away, or flat out oppose those needs. Also, history has shown that this fight isn't new to the area. From the creation of the industrial citrus agriculture, the power of post-war military manufacturing industries, to neoliberal globalization that's created the current logistics industry complex. It's always been about money and power, but there has always been resistance and resilience. And then at the bottom, the mural that's in the picture, I later came to find out that it was a project through the parole program that allowed parole kind of youth to participate in the community. And they were able to create this mural that you see in the picture also of the adobe, and kind of just wanted to give credit to the person who did that.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Jesus.
Alexis Muriel, are you here to share with us about your piece? Well, she entitled it, We Can't Breathe. So this has been,
hello.
Oh, good. Good, you're here.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. First, I also, just like a few other, artists, wanted to say thank you for the recognition and for selecting my piece as one of the winners. And everybody else, you all had wonderful, amazing pieces. I'm glad I was able to see them. I guess I'll just say a little small blurb about the inspiration of my piece. So considering the theme, air and justice, I was moved to create my art piece to draw attention to how capitalistic greed and white supremacy work hand in hand to disproportionately harm communities of color through environmental damage, as just one example. And healing these damages starts with recognizing the realities of what's happening in our world today. That is my piece, We Can't Breathe.
Thank you. Really sums it up, doesn't it?
Yeah.
A lot of what's happened in the last year. We have an adult literary artist to congratulate, Barry Cutler. Are you here to
share about your Barry in the audience?
Okay. Congratulations, Barry. We have a poem from Cynthia Anderson. Are you here?
She is here.
Fantastic.
I think I clicked the wrong person. Excuse me, Adeline. Here we go. And hello, Cynthia.
Okay, I think I'm here.
You're here. So welcome.
Great, thank you. And thank you for choosing my piece. It's been really inspiring to see all the art and all the hear the writing that's been created. Theme, which I think is so important. My poem is an imaginary vision of a different kind of world we might live in. And it's called A New Earth. I want to live on a new earth where no one ever says, I can't breathe. Where the air is clear, clean, and pure, because millions of people planted trees every day of their lives until the lost forests were restored, where gas and oil were abandoned after the electric vehicle mandate and the transfer of power to rooftop solar installed for free on every home and business by repurposed military personnel as part of Operation Sanity, where the existence of pollution anywhere in any form came to be seen as a moral failure, no longer tolerated, eradicated at any cost. I don't want what I see, a broken, choking, dying planet of lies and greed and denial, but rather a future where climate justice and social justice are equal, and the words, "I can't breathe," are no more than a bad memory. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for your vision. So beautiful. So we are moving into, so we had our winners of categories, and then we had the top winners. So Lila Stewart, our second grade top winner in the visual arts category. Congratulations, Lila. Are you here with us?
Yes, I'm. They are here, and I'm moving them to panelists. There we go.
Hi.
Hi. Welcome. Congratulations, Lila.
Thank you.
Will you share with us about your piece?
It's about the Earth is happy because all the good stuff is going up and the bad stuff is going down. And for justice is the stuff on top, and the stuff that causes air pollution is on the bottom.
Well, good. It's in our favor then. We're your vision. The balance, yes, is increasing. Good. Our fifth grade top winner, Brooklyn Zepeda, are you here?
I do not see them in the audience.
Okay, well, we'll just congratulate you, Brooklyn.
And I think entry. Mary wanted to mention that this is for grades 3 through 5, the top winner.
Oh.
And the last was TK through 2, so.
Thank you for clarifying that. No, that's sure. It's true.
Yeah. Okay.
So this is our top elementary author, Adeline Found.
And she is here.
Wonderful. Hi, Adeline.
Hello.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Are you up for sharing your essay with us?
Yes, I have it right here.
Wonderful.
I wrote clean air for all. Factories, trash, smoke, and carbon dioxide. These all pollute the air, and it's just not right. Everyone should have access to clean air, even people where pollution and factories are common. We could help solve this problem by planting trees and other plants which take in carbon dioxide and help our air. Or we could further promote the use of electric cars, which would mean less carbon emissions as well. Another solution is to encourage solar panels. We could also recycle more and spread the word. There are so many actions we can take to make clean air more available, and we definitely should. If each of the about 8 billion people in this world planted a tree, the amount of carbon dioxide would go down about 6%. So if you all planted a tree, we would have helped Earth's carbon craziness. Planting a tree is a simple deed, and if we all did it, it would have a good effect on the Earth. When you plant a tree, that tree uses the carbon dioxide in the air and makes food. So it uses the carbon dioxide, and humans can get rid of it. Electric cars are expensive, but really help. If electric cars are promoted and more people want them, eventually they will become common and cost less because more people have one. That way, when the price is lower, the families who couldn't recently afford them can, after everyone who has made them more common and lowered the price. Electric cars don't use gasoline, which when burned creates carbon dioxide and other harmful gases. Solar panels rock. They're another way to avoid using gasoline, so it's a win. Along with that, they use the sun, which is a renewable resource, so it never runs out. There are big places where solar panels are used, and these big places create a lot of energy. But the largest one is 3,200 acres. Wow. Not everybody has 3,200 acres of empty land or enough solar panels, but rooftop solar panels can also help power your home, and every little change helps. Recycling is another way to keep the air clean for everyone. Recycling avoids using landfills, which release methane, a harmful greenhouse gas. People who may live near landfills are exposed to this gas in their air. If we recycle more, we can make the air better for those people, and we don't have to make more things get thrown away. When we recycle, we use the old paper, glass, and cardboard to make new things with these products. For example, if you have a cardboard box, you throw it in the trash, polluting the air with methane. But if you had recycled that box, that could have been made into a new box. So tell all your friends that it's good to recycle and help Earth there. In conclusion, there are many ways we can help air pollution slow down, and we should try our best to do them all. We can plant trees, use electric cars, use solar panels, and recycle. We should all do our part to help the world, and it doesn't have to be a big task.
So great to hear your essay in your voice. Thank you. You have a wonderful message to share. I hope you can share that with a lot of people. And we'll share it out too. Congratulations, Adeline. We have a tie for the top 6th to 8th grade entries. And this spoken word by Sabina Arevalo Sierra is really amazing. Are you here to share it? Or actually, it's a video. Are you here to speak about it, Sabina? Well, we'll share the video, and if you can come on if you're here. Ask your words. Okay, good.
Sabina, if you want to unmute. Hello. There we go. Okay.
Hi.
Hi.
You can share it first if you want.
Hi, my name is Sabina, and today I'll be reciting my spoken word poem, Changed by One. Thank you. One person, one change, retooled, repeated. A single person can change this overlooked yet profound error of humanity. Thrown aside by many, understood by few, changed by one. The air no longer our place for pure breaths. The air no longer our reliable home. The air no longer our lifeline. A lifeline killed by its own beneficiary, a clueless and careless and thankless one. But that same person, the person that is us, can be the change, changed by one. It's not just heat or dirty air. It's the roots of every story ever told. The roots of every accomplishment ever made. The roots of every death and every birth, all coming apart. Many people with ideals like Thunberg and Muir have fought for a change, but still, 1970 wasn't enough and never will. Because what we need is for you and for him and for her to become one. One person can change the course, but first we all must be unified, for that one person has the strength of the world. Our seas, our air, our land, all of this on which we stand. It is ours to reap, but to sow as well.
So amazing. Thank you so much. for sharing and how great that you have a video.
Thanks.
To share up.
I just want to say the two parts of the theme are just, they're so connected in the way that one affects the other. It's a moral obligation for us to look after our air, the thing that has sustained their existence for so long. It's the justice that our environment deserves. What I most wanted to communicate was that if we're going to fight against air pollution, we have to do it together as a united front, as one, changed by one.
It's a perfect message. Thank you. Congratulations, Savina, for your awesome work. And here we have the other top middle school entry, Tyler Hernandez. Are you here with us, Tyler?
I don't see a hand, but I'll go to share this. Okay.
We're killing the earth, and that's really fun. No one believes us because we are young. Our forests are turning to ash in a second. Ask California, they'll tell you about it. They'll tell you how they have lost all their homes while Trump turns a blind eye and tweets on his phone. Global warming's an expensive little hoax for the last time. This is not a joke. Our factories are working in toxins, emitting the ozone is crumbling, and we won't stop putting chemicals in what we're trying to breathe. Our future is stolen, and we are the thieves. Sea levels are rising, and icebergs are melting. The coral reefs are dying, and no one is helping. Do you realize they keep the oceans alive? This started back in 1985. Don't come to me when your child can't think of what a tiger is, cause they're extinct. Don't cry to me when your fur coat ain't clean. The endangered list is now 41,416. Dear 2045, I don't think we're gonna survive. If you end up hearing this story, I just wanna say, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Tyler. Congratulations.
Bear with me as I get us back where we were. And this is our top middle school, so 6th through 8th grade visual arts winner, Carolina Loera. Are you here with us, Carolina?
She is here.
Hello.
Hello.
First I want to say thank you for choosing me. I'm really honored and excited.
So we love your piece. Congratulations.
Thank you. So what I decided to draw were three people protesting against, for equality and clean air. I decided to draw them diverse to show how everyone can support and help an important cause. And in the background, I decided to draw three power plants emitting air pollution and to show how it pollutes the whole air. So again, thank you.
Thank you so much. And now for our top middle school authors, we have a tie. Heidi Rivera has a wonderful poem. Are you here to share it with us, Heidi?
Yes, I'm here. Yay. Okay, so my poem is called Ignorant Reality.
Ghostly figures fog the sky with grim intent. They dissolve through the dusk cement, where those in debt survive to suppress these ghostly figures who thrive on the oppressed. And therefore, to an extent, there will be some regret. These woeful souls cease to forget. Those who ignore our state through a past erased, and breathless battles they sought through Psalms hate, with lands of countless beatings, founded the one that had the most meaning. Our open wounds still need to find their treating. Traitors surround our faded lair, accompanied by a simple prayer that our home would soon be greater. Until the damage has finished, shall we all diminish, for it is us that did this. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing it with us. And Emma Carranza is also our top middle school entry. Are you here to share your essay, Emma?
I see her in the audience. Here we go. Emma, if you want your camera on, you can, or if not, just speak.
I wrote my essay on the Salton Sea because I live close to the Salton Sea, and there are a lot of people who are less fortunate there who are struggling with the air pollution and the toxic dust that it gives off because it's drying up. So I wrote about how we need to come together as one to stop this before it and help those who can't speak up before it gets out of hand and before it affects everyone in the valley.
Were you going to read from your essay, Emma, or would just the summary enough?
I just wanted to summarize it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for addressing this most important topic that's in our backyard. So we really appreciate you bringing people's attention to the Salton Sea. We have Miria. Miriel Cabebe is our top special needs entry in our art contest. Are you here, Miriel, to share about your art?
Oh, I see her in the audience. If you want to raise your hand, you'd like, okay, here we go. And then feel free to just speak, or if you want to turn your camera on, then we can see you.
Okay. So I made this and because it represents all four seasons of the earth and you don't know what else to say, so.
Okay.
Congratulations. Thanks. It's a wonderful piece.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome. Our top 9th through 12th grade visual artist, so high school artist, is Albert Young. Congratulations, Albert. Are you here to share?
I don't see Albert in the audience.
Okay. We have a tie for top high school authors. Alice Peng, are you here to share your poem?
She is here.
Congratulations, Alice. We're so happy you're here with us.
Oh, you pinned me by mistake, Katie.
Oh, you guys move. All right. Sorry about that, Mary. Here we go.
Hi.
Hey. Hi, Alice.
So my poem is titled Air Depleting Beware. So you've heard of the American Revolution where all of our colonists fought for independence. And this is the Green Revolution where we fight for the very air we breathe. So for all those out there who say it's fine, that it's not our problem, no need for refine. Well, I'm here to tell you that this is a sign we need to take action because we've been out of line. Air pollution is a massive deal. We can no longer say it's unreal. From our usage of coal to automobiles, it's truly our Achilles heel. Air pollution can cause long-term disease. Our lungs will suffer and cause us to wheeze. More harm will come with every breeze. Please, I'm begging you, help stop pollution, please. Let us all start by biking or walking, because fossil fuels certainly are helping. If everyone does one little thing, oh, all the good it could bring. Stop chopping all the plants and trees. They provide the air we need to breathe. The same goes for oceans. There's no littering, please. It's all connected, don't you see? So think to the future of every child, every time they innocently laughed and smiled. Pretty soon, this pollution won't be mild. In years, the quality of air will be wild. So throw away those cigarettes. Our precious air isn't up for bets. Don't wait until they become regrets. It's important for everyone, even pets. Please, I'm begging you, help save our air. Not a single breath is left to spare. Our time is limited, so please beware. Take initiative and start to care. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing. Congratulations, beautiful poem. And Jessica Liu, our other top high school literary artist, are you here to share your poem?
It's here.
Oh, good. Congratulations, Jessica.
Jessica, feel free to unmute. Okay.
I'm not going to turn my camera, though. I hope that's okay. Okay, so my poem was titled Gray Earth. It's divided into four subsections. So yeah, okay, I'll start. One, world. Gray matter winds its way along pure air currents. Tainted forever, breathe nothing except small rocks and smoke swallowed. See the choking curls wrapping around delicate throats, choking. Earth heaves to breathe. Plants wither green to gray. Animals lay to sleep for eternity, lungs lined with pain, past millions of silver monsters, rushing past factories built of smoke. Fossil fuel giants emerged from human greed. In the city, you struggle to speak, sweat mixing with blood and tears, food served on platters crafted by your own hands to be heard past thousands of breaths, rattling inside their gas-filled sanctuaries. Watch your children, born from mother's womb, nurtured by Earth's gentle caresses, cough and cough, speckled gray on their hands, surrounded by sky rises and cracked sidewalks, broken dreams and thousands of the same. You have no answer to their cries and labored coughs. Past the rolling hills where Earth spares pureness for beloved nature green, sparse houses built on foundations constructed by piles of money. They enjoy the sweetness of nature's breath, Earth nurturing the successful. They pray for happiness and nothing more. Aborted gestures of kindness paused halfway. And as they sit on green bills lined with gold, your children choke to breathe in their nightmare laden sleep as red specks mix with gray on innocent hands. But watch. Watch around you as opened eyes block polluting enemies. And watch as Earth rolls back gray skies of gray olden days, sparing a breath of fresh air for your children, for the choking cities, and watch how second appearance grows longer with each day. Watch how your children laugh under the sun, shining from previously smoky skies skipping across cracked sidewalks, dreams mended, and watch progress. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Jessica. Congratulations. And we have a tie for our top performing artists at the high school level. William McKell, are you here to share your film?
I don't see William in the audience, but I'll go ahead and click over.
That's great.
The year is 2075. Fossil fuels destroyed the Earth. Oxygen bandits roam. What's left?
Sudden movements.
Bill?
Steve?
No way. This can't be real.
It's been like 3 years.
It's been forever.
I almost shot you.
I almost stabbed you.
How did it get like this?
Fossil fuels, man. They didn't listen to the science. They let the world become to this wasteland all because of fossil fuels.
If only we used renewable energy instead.
Meanwhile, in an alternate reality where fossil fuels were abandoned and renewable energy was utilized instead.
Hey, Bill.
How you been?
I've been great. I mean, look at all this. It's beautiful.
Yeah, I thought I'd take a day off and just admire the scenery.
And the cherry blossoms are about to be in bloom.
Yeah.
Springtime.
No, I was thinking of heading over to the orchard.
Great idea. How about I join you?
All right, let's head over there.
All right.
Looks like some good oranges over here. Yep. Catch! Some orange.
No way. I haven't seen one of these in years.
Does this mean life is still sustainable?
It has to, even if it's one single orange.
Maybe, even though those who came before us did not do Mother Nature justice, we can take the first step.
So good. So congratulations, William. And we have a tie for this category of top high school performing artists. Peter Lee, are you here? Well, we congratulate you on the amazing piece.
He is here.
Oh, he's here. Oh, good.
He's here. Okay. Peter, if you want to go on screen, turn on your camera. Otherwise, you can just speak.
Hey, Peter. Congratulations.
Thank you. I'll talk after the video.
Did you know that the internet produces pollution? Every single action or command sent throughout the internet is processed by data centers throughout the world. This includes clicking a link, sending a text, or joining a video call. These data centers hold thousands of servers, which all require an energy source and external cooling to run. To fuel these data centers, massive amounts of fossil fuels and other non-renewable energy sources are consumed, emitting tons of CO2 in the process. This form of pollution is called digital pollution, and it's becoming a demanding issue in today's world. Although it only accounts for 4% of the global air pollution, the rapid spread of technology is making this number increase exponentially. In just 4 years, the emissions produced by digital pollution is expected to double. Not only does it contaminate the air we breathe, but the CO2 emitted by digital pollution gets trapped in the atmosphere, gradually warming up the Earth's surface. As the Earth's temperatures get hotter and hotter, more extreme weather and natural disasters will occur. Furthermore, the spread of CO2 throughout the Earth directly contaminates the food we eat and the water we drink. Although members of first world countries may not directly experience these effects, the issues caused by digital pollution will heavily influence the lives of those in lesser developed countries, who depend solely on nature for survival. Those in indigenous communities are most prone to contaminated CO2 and extreme weather. Therefore, it is important for us to monitor our emissions not only for our sake, but for the sake of others as well. So how do we decrease digital pollution? Of course, as technology has become a necessary part of our lives, it would be impractical to completely stop using the internet. However, there are many small things that every user can do in order to decrease their carbon footprint on the internet. First, instead of searching for a website in Google, type the website link directly into the search bar. Each Google search emits about 0.5 to 0.7 grams of CO2. Though this number may seem small, when accounting for the 40,000 Google searches occurring per second, this number becomes a lot more meaningful. Furthermore, make sure to close tabs that are not in use. Second, delete any useless emails in your inbox. Receiving or sending an email from one person emits 20 grams of CO2, the equivalent of turning on a light bulb for 1 hour. Something as simple as deleting spam mail in your inbox can contribute greatly towards reducing digital pollution. If you have any email subscriptions that do not get opened, make sure to unsubscribe. Lastly, try to download movies or music. Streaming services account for 60% of the global data flow. If possible, download your favorite songs or movies to avoid carbon emissions. Anyone can make these changes. Why not start today?
Yeah, so thank you for the award, first of all. But more importantly, I think it's really significant that we raise awareness for like digital or internet pollution, because I actually had no idea about, I had no idea that the internet could produce pollution until like a few months ago when I was just clicking around on like YouTube and watching videos. But I just thought it was unfathomable how the internet could produce pollution of all things. And I think there are many others like me that don't imagine how the internet could produce pollution. And I think it's really important to raise awareness for this issue, because the importance of the internet is only going to increase. So I think we should start trying to like monitor this pollution while we can.
Agreed. And thank you for educating many of us. I didn't know a lot of what you shared, so thank you so much for that. And you gave some really good helpful tips as well. So together we can make a difference. So I hope that your documentary goes far and wide to help educate people. So thank you. Congratulations again. Now for our top high school visual artist. Let's see. So, here we are. So for our top high school visual art, Malia Miguel, you are a top winner. Are you here to join us today?
She is here.
Fantastic.
joining us shortly. Here we go.
Congratulations, Malia. What a powerful piece. So happy you're here to share.
Hi. thank you for considering my piece. And I would like to share some words about it. So my artwork illustrates the air injustice theme by primarily focusing on the act of redlining, which began as part of FDR's New Deal, where the government color-coded neighborhoods. A main cause of environmental injustice arose from this practice, so I wanted to emphasize its effects. I did this by drawing a red line down the middle of a neighborhood to clearly show the unfair boundaries. The red zone was deemed to have lower property values and higher risks of pollution. This zone also had a high population of minorities. This is juxtaposed by the good areas indicated by green, and this division of area was also reflected by the maps I used as a background. By including the protesters in the red area along with the cutout of Lady Justice, I was able to convey that the call for environmental justice is ongoing.
Thank you. Yeah. Amazing. Really wonderful art piece. Powerful. Our top adult author, we have Ginger Galloway. Are you here with us, Ginger?
She is here.
Hi.
Hey, hi. Congratulations.
Thank you.
At the top entry.
I am excited about the addition of the literary arts in the competition. This is awesome. And I am delighted by the artwork and the performing arts and the literary arts that I've seen today. I'm going to read my piece. And if you can imagine a time when breath is apportioned, so everybody has a certain amount of breath to take, and an alarm sounds in the town where you live to tell you when to breathe, to regulate your breathing. The alarm called out through the streets. Tamara concentrated on inhaling as she watched the number turn over on her counter. Only 7 more. She must have dreamed while she napped. Knowing she wouldn't remember it, she didn't even try. Exhaustion wreaked havoc on her memory, and it was only the most precious things that she bothered to try to recall. She slid her feet off her bed, pausing momentarily before she stood. Averting her eyes from the sunlight pouring in through the curtain, she let her gaze fall on Bella. Tamara nodded a silent thanks, preserving actual words for her sister. This would be the last day. She must choose her words carefully. Crying and excitement caused heaving. Tamara felt her heart quicken and closed her eyes. The alarm called her name. She relaxed the muscles in her chest and willed her lungs to receive beyond their capacity. If she could skip an alarm, she would not be wasteful. From the apartment above, the hush shuffle of feet sounded like childhood secrets. The elderly widow moved stealthily through an indoor forest of broadleaf trees, potted vegetable and fruit plants, and hanging ferns. A singular path led from her reclining chair to the toilet. She outlived her family with precise difference and restraint. She ate when hungry, only enough to ease hunger pains, and drank nothing. Breathing independent of the alarms, she touched each growing thing with long wrinkled fingertips. Surely they lived off her love and a steady stream of sunshine on every side, every window unencumbered by curtains. 2 stories down, dust covered the furniture, a small birthday cake rotting on the table. The scent of decomposition contained by towels methodically wedged into the heels of doors. A young couple, decidedly ignorant, or defiantly so, took their last breath together, allowing a single candle to burn on her 25th birthday. Their counters spun wildly as they wrapped themselves in each other's arms. The alarm sounded as they took their last breath. Bella glistened as Tamara pulled the trigger of a small spray bottle. Bella was the sole survivor of Tamara's futile attempt to prolong their lives. Ficus Lyra. Turning poison into life, eventually there would be no tree great enough to save anyone within the apartment or without. Lost in thought, the alarm startled Tamara. Her heart raced, and without thinking, she inhaled two shallow gulps of air. Her counter ticked twice. If Melanie didn't wake soon, there would be no tale to tell. Their portion had been in accordance with their suffering, and they hadn't suffered. Arguing that point wasn't for the sake of fairness. Nothing was fair before, and in the end, nothing would be. Melanie stirred, waking abruptly, choking and coughing away several liters of oxygen. Focusing on her sister's face, she raised her eyebrows. Shifting a hopeful gaze at Bella, she allowed herself to inhale. Tamara couldn't lie. She couldn't smile. The debt had to be paid. The counters ticking their breath. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing the powerful writing. And here we have our top adult visual artist. Jamie, are you here?
They are. Okay. Amy, either turn your camera on or unmute. Okay.
That should work.
Yes.
Hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I want to first say how touched I am by all of the wonderful art, especially seeing so much creativity and passion about the environment from so many young people. So thank you for conducting this contest. And thank you for doing me a great honor by awarding me this this prize among all the stars that I've seen. So thank you. I was inspired to do this piece by an actual event, and it wasn't until recently that I learned people considered the term tree huggers to be negative. I always thought it was a good thing, and I've been prancing around saying I was tree hugger for years. So this was actually from an event in 1974 in India, and there were villagers whose they were cutting down the trees around their village, and they were desperate to save their trees. And there were over 200 of them that got together, and they did just this. They gathered around the trees and held hands and refused to let them cut the trees down. This was, as a reference, I used an actual photograph. And if you ever look through tree huggers photographs, you'll know which one it was, although the original photograph had four women in it, but I only had room on my page for three. So that is really what inspired this. And I actually painted it in honor of Earth Day this year. And I thought it was a good intersection of air and justice. So trees may not look like air, but they provide us with clean air to breathe. So thank you again so much. I'm very honored.
Oh, we're honored to have you in this competition and to share your beautiful art. And you're so gifted, Jamie. And we love this piece, so thank you so much.
Thank you.
Congratulations. And that concludes our artists. Do we have time to honor World Environment Day, Katie?
I think we do, if you want to tell them about the video while I pull it up.
Okay, perfect. World Environment Day is a United Nations event, and you know, we have been trying to celebrate Earth Day every day. I mean, those of us that love the Earth know that. So we're trying to extend it beyond April into the rest of the year. So, you know, we have this annual World Environment Day event in Palm Springs that hopefully next year we'll be able to invite you all to, hopefully as the world opens up again. But the United Nations, this is, you know, a global event that people all over the world are celebrating today. So it's actually today, June 5th, every year. And this year's themes are reimagine, recreate, restore. So that's, and they have a short video that they produce that's lovely. So we wanted to share it with you in honor of World Environment Day 2021.
Have you ever seen time fly? Watch it slip through your fingers like a cloud passing by. Too slow to notice it leaving, too fast to make it stop. All we've known is to destroy like it's breathing. The pitter-patter of raindrops match the sounds of clocks tick, counting down. Tick, tick. How lucky we are to live. We are a fraction of a second in Earth's lifetime, yet she is our only lifeline. Resilient, we stand on our own two feet. I'll tell you, reimagining the future has never tasted so sweet. Like nectar to a bee, honey to a home. No one can do this alone. Tick. The promise of restoration lives within us. We see her in the hues of the youth, and she's asking you, what will you stand for? Now is the time for our regeneration.
Perfect. Thank you to all of our artists for being here. And now it's my great pleasure to introduce to you Mary Walls, who is the Vice Chair of the Environmental Education Collaborative, and she is the brains behind her amazing consulting company, Action Driven Inquiry. Mary is a dream to work with for me personally. She's created our beautiful flyers for this contest, and she's been with me behind the scenes of this contest every step of the way. So Mary, thank you so much for you, and take it away.
Thank you, Jen. Wanted to thank all of the partners that helped make this project doable, from financial support, from the Pony Barnes Foundation, and from the Palm Springs Sustainability Commission. So thank you so much. And then partners that helped organize this, especially Inlandia Institute and Katie Porter, who is our host today. This live virtual event would not be possible without Inlandia. So thank you so much. And Rivers and Lands Conservancy for helping with judging and organizing. And I wanted to thank all the families present, all the artists present, all the community support that's present. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being part of seeing the amazing talent in our region. And for those of you artists out there that have been honored today, in the mail, you will be getting certificates and Visa check cards in the mail. So keep an eye out for that in the next couple weeks. And Katie started our session together, honoring the people of our lands. And so I wanted to end with that and honor the people of the lands we live and work on, past, present, and future. And thank you all for sharing your visions and your imagination and creativity, imagining what our region can be, a healthy and sustainable future. So thank you all very much.
Thank you, Mary. Thank you, Katie. Thank you, everyone that's joined us today.
Thank you all. And thank you both to Mary and Jen for coordinating this contest and for inviting us to be a part of it. So with that, I think we will all bid you a good afternoon, and we will be together again sometime. Thank you.
Bye. Come gather up, people, wherever you are.